This is William B. Williams for the United States Army Reserve. Our guest today is Petula Clark. We have the star-studded Las Vegas nightlife spot thing. We are backstage at the Riviera Hotel in Vegas with its star, Petula Clark. How often do you come over to work Vegas?
Oh, I have about 5 or 6 weeks here, and we can split that up how we want. You know, it can either be 3 weeks at a time, which is a bit long, or 2 weeks and another 2 weeks and then a week. But it doesn't mean our coming all the way over from Europe. We don't live in America, you see.
I mentioned coming over because you make your home now in Switzerland, as I understand it.
Yes, I'm married to a Frenchman.
Mm-hmm.
And I lived for several years in Paris, and then we decided we wanted a quieter life when I wasn't actually working. We now have 3 children, and we live in a very, very pretty part of the world. We live in Geneva, Switzerland.
Isn't there a part of Switzerland, Pat, a particular town where one supposedly can stand at some spot in that town and see 4 countries at once?
Oh, probably, yes. It's not Geneva, anyway.
No,
Basel? Basel, probably, yes. That sounds more like it.
And you can see, I had heard you could see 4 countries at once.
Well, from where we live, we can see the Alps, the French Alps.
Mm-hmm.
We can see the old town and the countryside and the lake and another chain of mountains. It's really a spectacular place to live.
Also just occurred to me, why would anybody want to see 4 countries at once?
Well, it's nice to say you can see them.
That's right, that one can look and see 4 countries at once. In this country, I know you work Vegas, but you haven't worked too many other cities in the colonies, have you?
Colonies?
Well.
You said that.
I know I did.
No, I haven't, and that's why this time I decided I wanted to stay here a bit longer to travel around. And usually I come over, I arrive like 2 days before I open in Vegas,
mm-hmm.
and I'm still on jet lag. I do opening night, and as soon as I've finished, I jump straight back on a plane to Geneva, and the shock to the system is pretty rough.
It takes a while, I would imagine, to acclimate.
Yes. Yeah. Because Geneva, too, is a very quiet, very staid sort of place to live, and coming straight into Las Vegas is...
Oh, what an incongruity from that to Vegas. If you can hear music in the background, we're talking, as I said earlier, in the dressing room of Pat Clark at the Riviera Hotel. That's very soft music in the background.
Mm-hmm. That's the dining music, I suppose. It's coming over the speakers in the dressing room. We can't seem to switch them off.
This is a 24-hour town,
oh,
Vegas.
Yes.
And you were talking earlier about living in a quiet little town in Geneva.
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever bring the children over here to Vegas?
Oh, yes, the children are with us now.
Ah.
Oh, they love it here. They love it because the weather's marvelous, mm-hmm. and they can go over to Circus, and I don't know what they get up to over there. Circus is a very special place. It is a gambling
casino. But they also have the trapeze acts.
Yes, and it does cater to children. There aren't many places where they do.
I was just going to say, that's a problem here in Vegas, because families come here and should, but when you walk through into the hotel, you walk immediately into the casinos, yes. and the youngsters obviously are not allowed to play
mm-hmm.
at any of the games, and they stand there. I know my son is out here with me, and he's bugged about the fact that they won't let him play the slot machines.
Mm. Well, he should go to Circus. I think they even have a discotheque for little ones over there.
The trials and tribulations of a star working in Vegas. My guest is Pat Clark. Right now, this word for the Army Reserve. Petula Clark. Good sounds. Have you been influenced in your singing by any one other performer? As a child in the English music halls, did you steal away and listen to someone's recordings?
We had some good singers in England when I was a kid, and of course, probably you never even heard of them over here, because at that time...
Try me.
Anne Shelton?
Oh, yes.
Really?
Sure.
Oh, she's
good singer, yes.
Really? She still is. Well, Joe Stafford I always enjoyed, and Peggy Lee, of course,
mm-hmm.
I've worshipped for a long time, Lena Horne. But I don't think I really tried to copy them. I don't think I fashioned myself on anything.
No, I was just wondering about an influence upon you.
Not really. I was always influenced by jazz, and then eventually by rock, by that kind of music, mm-hmm. if you like.
Who impresses you among the contemporary? You mentioned rock. Among the contemporary rock performers, or what group impresses you?
Hey, there are so many, so many marvelous performers. I think it would be unfair for me to name one. Of course, Elton John I adore because I love the way he sings, but I love his approach to music in general. And the girls, too, who are fabulous. I love Carly Simon's sound. There are so many, mm-hmm. I really would prefer not to mention names because I'm going to leave somebody out.
Now, Tony Hatch played a vital part in your recording career. And the number of hit songs he wrote for you.
Very clever young man.
Yeah.
He wrote Downtown, I Know a Place, Don't Sleep in the mm-hmm. Subway, Color My World, Who Am I, Call Me.
Well, that was a real string of hits for you.
Yeah, about 10 of them, yes.
Yeah. That must be a marvelous thing because you walk out on stage and as soon as you go into the first few bars of tunes like that, they are so recognizable and people have liked them so much that there's the applause and it's I'm sure it's a big kick for you.
It is very nice, but I'm not sentimental. I don't live in the past, mm-hmm. and I would like to go forward now. I'd like to really go on from where I left off musically a few years ago, and maybe I'll have to write the songs myself, and that's exactly what I'm doing.
Earlier you were talking about, Pat, about doing new things now. The new act that you do is just that, isn't it? It's a almost completely new act.
Yes, it is. And we were talking about all the hit songs. Well, I open my act with three really big hit songs, with Subway, I Know a Place, and Downtown. And I more or less, if you like, throw them away mm-hmm. by opening with them. Because, people have come to hear those songs.
But isn't that a gamble in one sense?
Yes, but it's an exciting gamble because from then on I really have to prove to the audience that I can do other things. And that's part of the gamble. I rather like it, and mm-hmm. I think people like it too.
I guess a performer must do that, really, because if you stay with the same things that obviously have been successful for you, at some point you're going to just kind of drift mm-hmm. backwards, and I guess in every sense you have to always move forward. Sometimes audiences seem to resent, though, not hearing familiar things all the time.
I know that, and of course I could go on stage and simply do all the hit songs mm-hmm. one after another, do them all the way through.
That'd be the easy way out, though.
Yes, but I honestly think that the audience would feel in some way disappointed. Mm-hmm. I like them to go out feeling that they've seen something that they weren't expecting to see, you know, and it makes it more fun for me.
Sure. And also, I guess at some point, those things that are new become, at some point, hopefully, things that they come to know and love and are familiar. My guest is Pat Clark. We are backstage at the Riviera Hotel. That's a marvelous name, incidentally.
Do you think so?
Yes.
No,
even shortening it to Pat is beautiful, but Petula, the full sound of Petula Clark. Even if you had never sung a note in your life, that name deserves to be, you know, because tonight, Petula Clark, it sounds like you should be a star.
Well, you make it sound very nice, but I really don't like my name.
No?
No.
Given your druthers, what would you rather have as a first name?
Oh, I love my second name.
Which is?
Sally.
Sally Clark.
That's
can
not
I be,
bad.
Can I be honest with you? Mm-hmm. Sounds like a stripper in Baltimore.
Hey, maybe that's what I really want to be.
My guest has been a stripper. No, my guest has been Pet Clark. I thank you, Petula.
Thank you.
And this is William B. Williams reminding you that in the Army Reserve, part of what you earn is pride. We are backstage at the very chic Riviera Hotel in Las Vegas with Petula Clark, who is appearing here. So that's quite appropriate that we should be backstage, I guess.
Yes, in a rather flamboyant dressing room.
I know. I think it's the most charming dressing room.
You do?
Do you like working Vegas?
Yes, I do. It's a very exciting place to work, you know, because there are so many exciting performers around you. Mm. You know, there's always something going on here. It's a very special sort of place. It's fun.
It's almost a mecca for show folk, really, in the sense, as
it
you
is.
Said, there are so many hotels on the strip here, and so many big performers come out here to earn their bread. And you're on the show here with the Righteous Brothers. I mentioned the Righteous Brothers, it seems to me that you're getting more and more into more and more contemporary music. Or am I hearing things wrong?
I don't know. I've always been into contemporary music. My records, when I was making big hit records, they were contemporary songs with a contemporary sound to them. And perhaps my records over the last few years haven't sounded all that, well, contemporary, whatever that means exactly. That's because producers haven't been giving me the right material, I think. But when I go on stage, I do exactly what I want to do, and I do feel contemporary music. That's the way I feel about music.
You work here with a group in back of you.
Yeah, this is a new thing. This is a whole different act I'm doing here. Mm-hmm. I'm doing a little dancing, and we have, I have my usual three girls backing me up and my own rhythm section. But we have four marvelous young boys who sing and dance, called The Friends. And
Better than enemies.
Right. And they're lovely. They're very young, very enthusiastic.
My guest is Petula Clark, and as I said, we are backstage at the Riviera Hotel in... Do you mind being called Pet?
Oh, most people call me Pet.
So. In Pet's dressing room, and I wonder, given the opportunity, it seems to me that you mentioned that in the act now you do dancing and so forth. Given the opportunity, are there feels of the entertainment, in the entertainment milieu that you haven't entered yet that you want to?
Mm.
Areas
yes.
That you haven't? Like what?
Like the theater.
Mm-hmm.
Like a Broadway show, which my friends say I must be mad to want to do. I mean, friends like Anthony Newley or, well, Barbara Streisand, they said to me, hey, you don't want to do that. You know, it's... And they've done it, so
yeah.
I suppose they should know. They feel it's terribly hard work, terribly risky, and financially it doesn't mean a thing. But,
and also, I'm sure they suggest that you are at the mercy of about five or six critics in New York, in the sense that the New York drama critics seem to have a great hold over what the public ends up seeing if they put thumbs down on a particular show.
Yes,
although that isn't always true. There are times, I'm sure you know, where the critics have not been enthralled with the show and the public likes it.
Well, that's the kind of show I'd like to do, a show that the public wants to see. And, of course, the critics like, of course. It's always nice to have good reviews, of course. But I would really like to do a really earthy musical with great music. Maybe one day I'll get it, I don't know.
In England, of course, they have the Music Hall.
Yes.
And it's a great spawning ground.
Yes.
Great apprenticeship is served there by...
Well, unfortunately, the English Music Hall is over. We're trying to bring it back. That's to say, the people are trying to bring it back because they enjoy it. It's a kind of audience participation. But the real English Music Hall that I used to do as a kid, unfortunately, the theatres are closed. So that's really the problem.
Yeah. Did you hear a door open?
Yes, that's
the
my
theaters
husband.
May be closed in England, but the doors are opening in Vegas. My
and
guest,
they're squeaking.
My guest is Pet Clark. This word now for the United States Army Reserve. You record, I tell you this in all candor, and I mean it, it's marvelous for guys who play recordings on radio to play your recordings because the music you record and the sound you make is never a chaser. By that I mean there are certain artists who will grab one part of an audience and hold them, but they lose another. They chase either the younger element or the older element. But when we play your music, we know that it goes right across the spectrum, and it's not a chaser, and that's good from my point of view. And I'm sure it must be a kick from your point of view to realize that both the young and the older audience dig you.
Well, that is nice to know, yes. I honestly don't think about it, though. It's something which is done not consciously at all. I really do sing what I like to sing, and it's a very pleasant accident that so many people do enjoy it.
Is that always available to you as a performer to select the music you want, or are there times when you have to bow to the dictates of the recording industry, or
well,
the recording moguls?
The recording moguls. Well, I do have a problem. When I was doing, you know, Downtown and all those marvelous songs that were big hits for me a few years ago, they were written for me by one man.
Tony
Hatch. Mm-hmm. And just the way that Burt Bacharach was writing hits for Dion. Tony was doing the same for me. And then Tony just stopped writing hit songs. And since then, really, I have been having a problem finding the right material. Sometimes I've found it with This Is My Song, for instance, which was not a Tony Hatch song, Charlie Chaplin.
Right.
That worked. But since then, it is a problem finding the right producer who can find the right material. Yes.
My guest is Pet Clark. We are backstage in Vegas, Las Vegas, at the Riviera Hotel. This word now from the Army Reserve. You mentioned earlier about how vital it is to find the right marriage of the performer and a writer. Is it also that vital in addition to the writing? And I've asked this question of many artists, and I'm sure you're going to say yes. The arrangement?
Of course, the arrangement is very, very important.
The vehicle that showcases the talent.
Yes, it can turn, a good orchestration can turn a medium song into a great record. But I don't think a great orchestration can turn a no-good song into a great record. I don't think it's quite as straightforward and easy as that. I wish it were. But I'm looking for great songs right from the beginning, you know.
The audiences that you encounter, face, play to as you go around the world. I guess I use the word encounter. Maybe that's the wrong word. That you play to, that you play to around the world. Do you find differences in audiences in various parts of this country or various parts of the world?
Well, in this country, I really haven't played in very many places over the last few years. I've just been coming back to Las Vegas, maybe Tahoe. I'm going to be in New York, I'm going to Cleveland, I'm going to San Francisco. I'll let you know in a little while the difference. But certainly in Europe, of course, the audiences are different to American audiences. Mm-hmm. Very different.
In what way?
French audiences, particularly Parisian audiences, are terribly hard, very brittle. They don't really enjoy stars, you know. The star comes on stage and the audience is inclined to sit on their hands.
Kind of a show me attitude.
Yes, all right, now prove it.
Yeah.
The Germans, in general, they all start applauding together and stop applauding. It's totally disciplined.
That's marvelous. I think that's peculiar to the German culture all the way through. My guest is Petula Clark. A word now for the Army Reserve. Petula, for taking time out from your encounter in Vegas.
Yeah, I enjoyed it.
Is this a brief encounter you're having? What is it, a two-week run?
No, this is just 1 week.
1 week. That is a brief encounter.
Yes. It's nice because 2 weeks here can be very hard work. We have two shows a night, seven nights a week, and the hours are rather strange, you know. It's quite hard work.
Well, you're doing, from what I hear and understand, a marvelous job. And again, my thanks to you.
Thank you.
Our guest has been Petula Clark, and this is William B. Williams reminding you that in the Army Reserve, part of what you earn is pride.